found this 28 SEA Games. It's mainly because you know, next year is Singapore's 50th birthday, and of course, last time Singapore held SEA Games was 20 years ago. So you know, we want to be in this once in a lifetime experience. And also, me, I volunteered with hardware for about 10 years already. So for me, it's more of self-improvement, trying to manage a bigger project, which naturally come with more difficulties. But for the volunteers, it's more of, you know, for them to experience SEA Games. I mean, they might only be involved in SEA Games once in their lifetime.
Okay, I'm Raj, I'm currently 19 years old, and I'm pursuing my second year diploma in mechanical engineering in Ngee Polytechnic. So basically, I'm here today, I'm a leader in for these SEA Games. What I have to do is that I have to lead a group of volunteers in this training to help them, to help this volunteer to learn and understand about what SEA Games is all about. The youth planning community has came up with games, ice-breaking games. So through this, right, what they can learn is that they can know the names of every single member in their group, so that on actual day, they can, you know, it's easier for them, they can communicate.
Okay, I'm Brian. I'm 20 this year, currently serving my national service. Okay, so I'm part of the youth planning committee under the operations and logistics department. We train the leaders first through two leaders training, as well as the volunteers, and you know, help get them in their groups and help them to interact with each other, as well as train them on the skills that they require for their spectator service officer role. Things can be very messy and rowdy, so they need to learn how to communicate effectively with the audience while maintaining being polite and friendly with them. People ask, like, you know, why we choose to volunteer, you know, especially for myself serving national service. You know, this type of free time could be better spent enjoying our time outside, but I guess it's the takeaway after the event is partially a sense of accomplishment, and also like having a chance to interact with the public and serving them. Yeah, and also the friends that you make. Like, I'm still in contact with my friends from Chingay 12. Yeah, you know, it's the friends that you make that, you know, that keeps you coming back.
First of all, as Singaporeans, we should, you know, support our Singapore athletes. You know, whether win or lose, we should support them nonetheless. And we should also support the volunteers who, you know, who contributed, you know, many hours in making the games possible. Yeah, so all the best.